In the cloud, you usually have three options. You can go with Intel, AMD, or some kind of IRM-based processor. In AWS, it's called Graviton, and they all have different prices. So the goal for this video is to find the true cost of the compute. We'll calculate how much it costs per 1 billion requests per month. And of course, the more throughput you get from the VM, the cheaper and more efficient that platform is. Also, I'll estimate what would be the average cost if you manage a medium-sized infrastructure with around 78 extra-large EC2 instances per month. We'll also measure latency, CPU usage, as well as memory usage. For this test, I'll be using the latest generation large instances. That would be Graviton 4 for the IRM. Then we have the Intel with a 3.2 GHz processor, and finally AMD with 3.7. Now, let's take a look at the prices. Again, the cheapest one is Graviton, which would be around $65 per month. Then we have Intel with around $73 per month. And finally, the most expensive and fastest processor is AMD with $84 per month if you use a 30-day billing cycle. As you can see, I have three different instances that use different EC2 instance types. Alright, let's go ahead and run the test. At the very beginning, when we have exactly the same throughput, the price per billion requests as well as the overall AWS bill will simply reflect the initial price differences between the VMs that I'm testing. And only at the end of the test, you will see the true cost. Also, you can notice that Intel is the slowest one, which makes sense because it has only 3.2 GHz compared to 3.7 for the AMD. It has the highest CPU usage, which would probably result in lower throughput overall. Let me run this test for one more minute. At the end, we'll go over each graph and you'll see the final prices. First, we have price per 1 billion requests, and as expected, Graviton has the best price efficiency. Then we have AMD, and the most expensive is Intel, even if it appears cheaper on paper. Next, let's take a look at the AWS bill that you could have if you choose one of these types. For Graviton, you would only have to pay $91,000. For AMD, $108,000. Which is 17,000 more. And the most expensive, which doubles the price, is Intel. So again, the more requests per second you can get from the VM, the more efficient it is. So by simply switching from Intel to Graviton, you can reduce the cost of your AWS bill by half and around 20% by switching from AMD to Graviton. Graviton is cheaper because cloud providers can make those chips themselves and make it cheaper for the end user. Next, we have throughput. Well, if you care only about efficiency, AMD is the fastest and provides the highest throughput. But because it's more expensive overall, it's actually better to switch to Graviton. And at the bottom, we have Intel. Next, we have latency measured from the client side. Intel is the slowest, then we have Graviton, and AMD has the lowest latency. Next, we have CPU usage. And finally, memory usage. So you can reduce your infrastructure cost by switching to cheaper IRM-based processors. The same applies to Google Cloud and Azure. Well, you still need to compile and build your applications for IRM-based architecture, but usually it's not a big deal. For example, you can use this Docker command to build this for AMD and IRM architecture, and even create a single manifest that combines these two images. And Kubernetes will automatically pull the correct image to match the underlying architecture.